Hi everyone, welcome to the next video in the series where we'll be covering everything you need to know about IRL live streaming. In the last couple of videos, I showed you how to set up the streaming apps you need for your phone and home PC, and how to stream with your phone on a local and remote network. Today I'm going to show you how to set up disconnect protection with Loopy SRT, which is an auto scene switching app for OBS. It monitors freezes and playback to automatically switch OBS between your live, low bitrate and offline scenes for you. We'll also look at a couple of ways to control your live stream, which is only possible because we got port forwarding to work in the last video. But if you're checking out my channel for the first time, watch the other videos in this series because I've already done a lot of the groundwork to get you to this point. Okay, the first step is to open the IRL Live folder from part 5 and add a new subfolder called Loopy SRT. Then to one side, open their GitHub page, link in the description, to download the latest release. Depending on whatever OS you're using, go with one of the first four download links. I'm on Windows, so I'll be downloading this one here with Portable in the name. Extract the file into the Loopy SRT folder we just made, then dig into the Loopy SRT subfolders where you'll find loopysrtmonitor.exe. Right-click the file and create shortcut, then move the shortcut to the topmost folder IRL Live and rename it to Loopy SRT. If you open the app now, you might get this error. Click More Info and run anyway. And then you should get another error, test 6 of 10 failed. And that's because we haven't configured the settings. Close the Loopy SRT window because we'll come back to it later. If we refer back to the releases page on the GitHub, Loopy SRT needs a separate app in order to communicate with OBS. There's two ways to do this, but we're going with the one they recommend, obs-websocket-http. The link for their GitHub page should be in the description just above downloads. Go to the releases page and then depending on your operating system, go with one of the first three download links. I'm on Windows, so I'm downloading this one into the same folder as the exe file for Loopy SRT. If you were to open Loopy SRT now, you'll notice the WebSocket file we just downloaded will open as well, but you'll still get this error, and that's because we still have some configuring to do. Go back to the Loopy SRT folder where you'll notice there's two config files. The one with default in the name is a backup. You'll need this just in case and for reference. The smallest typo in what we're going to be doing can break Loopy SRT, and it might be easier to start over using the backup file. Open the config.ini file, not the backup, with a plain text editor. This is where you can configure all of Loopy SRT's settings. I'm going to cover what you need to get up and running, but for an in-depth explanation of how this all works, you've got their GitHub and this README file here. I highly recommend you refer to them often, especially while you're trying to figure this stuff out on your own. Let's begin. From the top, change only the following fields, leaving everything else with their default settings. You can change them later if you want. For stream fail delay, replace 8 with 5. Scene OK is your live scene in OBS, replace main with scene cam 1. Scene fail is your offline or disconnected scene in OBS, replace BRB with scene BRB. Scene intro is your starting soon scene in OBS, replace intro with scene starting soon. Scene bypass is what you'd use for any scene where you don't want Loopy SRT to auto switch from to the BRB scene. For example, if your starting soon scene has your cam 1 as a small nested scene and your signal drops, Loopy SRT would switch OBS to your BRB scene when maybe you don't want it to do that until you're actually live. For now, replace none with scene starting soon. Let's add a few more non-auto switching scenes. Press enter to add a new line, then type scene bypass 2 equals scene ending soon. Then again for scene bypass 3 equals scene privacy. If you're wondering where the line is for LBR or low bitrate, Loopy already knows because we gave it the same name as scene cam 1, but with LBR at the end. Just having LBR at the end of that scene ensures that it's the LBR scene for Loopy SRT. Check out the README file for more info. Moving on, media source 1 is your media source on the cam 1 scene. Replace media source with source cam 1. Leave the line for WebSocket address, no changes here, but for WebSocket password, replace pass WS with your server password in OBS. Moving on to the low bitrate section, for scene LBR enabled, replace false with true. Scene LBR delay, replace 0 with 1. Then on to the OBS WebSocket HTTP section. For HTTP bind port, replace 4456 with 4457 because we'll need port 4456 for something else. For HTTP auth key, after the equals symbol, add your server password from OBS. Make sure there's no spaces like in this example here. Then scroll right to the bottom. For bind to address, replace 0.0.0.0 with 127.0.0.1. Bind to port, replace 4456 with 4457. Authentication key, add your server password in OBS with a space like in the example here. WS password, replace passws with your server password in OBS. Save the config file but keep it open. Then try opening Loopy SRT. If it gets blocked by your firewall software, make sure you allow access. Then try opening Loopy SRT again. But if you get the test 9 error, read through the message carefully. Start over with the scene names in the config section at the top of the config file. Copy the scene names from OBS directly rather than typing them. Sometimes the smallest typo can break this part of the code. While testing, I typed the source names rather than the scene names too. So little things like that can make a difference. Then check if you don't have any missing scene names for scene OK, scene fail, scene intro, and if you correctly named your bypass scenes from scene bypass, scene bypass 2, scene bypass 3, etc. Save the config file, and this time Loopy SRT should open without a problem, but please let me know in the comments if you do get an error so I can try and replicate it and make an update to this video. For everyone else, Loopy SRT should have switched OBS to your starting scene scene, and this is good. But let's do a couple of checks to make sure everything's working. Grab your mobile, make sure it's connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your home computer, and your IRL app from last time is open. Go into the settings, connections, and check the SRT local is ticked so you can go live when you tap the big grey button on the main page. Remember to make all the changes we talked about in part 6 or you get an error message in your IRL app like this one. This is one of those things you have to get used to doing before heading out to IRL livestream. The next test is to turn off your phone's Wi-Fi and switch your connection to SRT remote. If all goes to plan and there haven't been any major changes to Loopy SRT since I made this video, you should be good to go, but if there's any issues it could be for any of the following reasons. Make sure WebSocket server in OBS is checked or enabled. Check for typos in the config file, then rewatch the whole part of the video again because the smallest thing can break everything we've done so far. Now we're not done yet because you don't have a way to control, start or stop your live stream when you're away from home or a way to go to your privacy or ending soon scenes. The first way I'm going to show you works for both Android and iOS and it's an app called OBS Blade. Download and install the app to a second or support phone, not your primary streaming phone. It'll be easier this way. Open the app and swipe to add a manual connection to OBS. For the IP address field, enter your external IP address from part 6. Password is your server password in OBS. Save connection by giving it a name like IRL Live. All your scenes in OBS should now be accessible as clickable buttons. Try navigating between the non-auto switching scenes like starting soon, privacy, and ending soon. The three dots on top right give you options to start and stop streaming or recording in OBS. But make sure bandwidth test mode is enabled first before testing this out. So here's how you can use this app for IRL live streaming. First, you can check if Loopy SRT has switched to the starting soon scene. Then from the top right menu, you can start streaming in OBS to Twitch or wherever. From there, you can start broadcasting with the IRL app on your primary streaming phone using the SRT remote connection. Wait a few seconds to make sure you don't get any connection errors in your IRL app. Then in OBS Blade, you can tap on Scene Cam 1 to start interacting with your viewers. If you need to take a quick break, tap on the privacy scene, then back to Cam 1 when you're good to go again. For a longer break, stop broadcasting from your IRL app so Loopy SRT can switch OBS to your BRB scene. Also with OBS Blade, you can add lots more scenes in OBS that you can switch between, like gameplay, slideshow, or whatever. Then when you're ready to wrap up, tap on the ending soon scene, stop streaming from the menu at the top right, and you're done. The next way to control your stream is with Moblin, which is an IRL live streaming app for iOS. If you're on Android, I encourage you to keep watching because Moblin as an app are doing some really interesting things for the world of IRL. And I think it's good to know what's out there if you know what I mean. Anyway, if this app is new for you, we'll create a new connection or what they call a stream from scratch. Go into the settings, then streams, create custom and SRT LA. For the URL field, add your external SRT address from part 6. For stream ID, type anything, then next. For stream name, replace custom SRT with SRT remote. Also avoid the close or cancel button on the top right because you'll have to start over. Instead, you've got create at the bottom to save your new stream. Tap again to modify SRT remote. Scroll down to enable OBS remote control, then go into its settings. For the URL field, enter your external IP address using this format, ws://180.149.231.164:4455. Remember, this is a dummy address for demonstration demonstration purposes. Password is your server password in OBS. Source name is the CAM1 source in OBS. Tap back to save your changes, then close. Back on the main screen, look through the quick buttons for this one here, OBS. Then tap to reveal a list of stream settings and scenes from your instance of OBS, a lot like the other app, OBS Blade. If you get the unable to connect the OBS server error message, it's probably a typo in one of your settings, or your VPN or firewall software may be blocking the connection. Just do what you did in part 6 to get the SRT remote connection working, and you should be good to go. And with that, we've enabled disconnect protection and can control OBS using Moblin or OBS Blade, maybe both. But let's say you'd like to auto switch between two phones, or maybe have a picture-in-picture scene. I'll be covering how to do this in this video right over here. Please like and subscribe, because puppies. Thanks for watching, see you next time.